for this place, and we thank you for this opportunity that we have to come together and to honor Nicole and her accomplishment. And we pray that this evening would be a blessing to her. In Jesus' name, amen. Everything we said. Somewhere else. So, I want to start off. I've got a couple people that are going to come up and say something, and I'm going to say something, and we're going to do something else. But first, I want to say that we wouldn't be here except for the work of a lot of people. So, there's too many people that have contributed to getting tonight ready, and you know, Joy and worship team. Joshua stepped up when Mark was sick and did a great job. All the people that helped with the food. So we appreciate that. But the number one thing I want to start with is that the person who really got us to where we are right now, where Nicole was able to graduate, is her mom. And for those who are homeschool moms, you know that you work for years for this moment. And so we're not here without Donna. You know, she's spent 13 plus years of formal education, and the rest of it was informal. And so I can't, words can't express how much I appreciate my wife and the work that she put in, and the young woman that sits here that's graduating is a result of all of her hard work. So, thank you to my wife and to Nicole's mother. So with that said,
first of all, I would like to congratulate Nicole on this very special day that you've been waiting for a very long time. You have worked very hard to get where you are today, and we are all very proud of you and the things that you have accomplished. As you have been waiting for this day, God knew exactly how it's going to go. You may have found that it was very hard to wait for this day to arrive. I'd like to talk to you tonight about waiting on the Lord. I believe this is a very important thing for you to learn as you begin this new journey in your life. Most people do not have to wait for anything. Think of all the devices people have developed to minimize waiting. Microwaves, fast food, drive-thrus, credit cards, email, and texting, to name a few. These inventions may be convenient and helpful, but we will never escape seasons of waiting, because God knows how essential it is that we learn this quality. The Lord has different plans for each of us, but no matter who you are, God's plan for you includes stoplights. Think about some people in the Bible that had to wait. Abraham and Sarah, waiting for a child. Jacob, waiting for Rachel. Moses, waiting to enter the promised land, which he didn't get to do in the end. Elizabeth, waiting for her child. In every one of their lives, waiting played an essential role in bringing about God's perfect plan. We also wait here on earth. We wait for God's promises, Christ's return, and our home in heaven. You will also be waiting, Nicole, waiting for every single thing that will happen next in your life. And not only will you wait, you need to wait patiently for God's will in your life. Here are a few verses that tell us about waiting. In Psalms 27:14, it says, "Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart, and wait for the Lord." Psalms 130, verse 5, "I wait for the Lord, my soul waits, and in his word I put my hope." Psalms 41:1 says, "I waited patiently for the Lord, and he turned to me and heard my cry." In giving your life to God and letting his will be done, you will receive God's perfect plan for your life. Nicole, I would encourage you to be still and know that God has your life all planned out and under control. What may seem impossible to you is not for him. Psalms 46:10 says, "Be still and know that I am God." Rejoice and wait. This is very hard to do, but God says to do it. James 1:2 says, "Consider it pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds." Focus on the Lord instead of focusing on waiting. Learn to lean on the Lord for the little everyday things, so that when the bigger stuff comes along, you will know where to run. Psalms 25, 4-5 says, "Show me your ways, O Lord, teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior, and my hope is in you all day long." I know God has great plans for you in your life. Listen to him and let him control your life. Let him have control of your life, and you will be getting such a wonderful reward, God's perfect plan for your life. I will close with a verse of encouragement to do all these things. In Psalms 84, 11-12, says, "For the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord bestows favor and honor. No good thing does he withhold from those who walk whose walk is blameless. O Lord Almighty, blessed is the man who trusts in you." Nicole, God bless you and keep you as you go out into the world and shine your light for him.
Thank you, Jill. I guess I didn't think how hard this was going to be. So now